Morning, class. Today we're going to learn about the water cycle and its different causes and effects. Here I've given you a visual aid. We're going to focus on the evaporation, condensation, precipitation, and surface runoff of the water cycle. So first I'd like to present you with a list of vocabulary words. I want to make sure that we're all on the same page. Can anybody tell me what evaporation means? Yes.
Is evaporation when water changes the gas?
Yes, it is.
Liquid changes the gas?
So evaporation is a type of vaporization of a liquid that occurs from the surface of a liquid into the gaseous phase. So yes, from a liquid into a gas. Our next term is precipitation. Does anybody know what precipitation means?
Yes. Precipitation, an example of that would be like when it's raining.
Yes, like when
snowing.
It's raining. So any product of condensation of atmospheric water vapor that falls under gravity. So it could be snow, sleet, rain, or hail. Now what would depend to make it either rain, snow, or sleet?
Maybe the temperature?
Right, the temperature. So if it's very warm out in the summer, we can get, you know, snow showers. But if it's very cold during the winter, we'll get either sleet or snow, depending on how cold it really is. Our next term is condensation. Condensation happens in the atmosphere, in the clouds. It is a change of the physical state of matter from gas into liquid, and is the reverse of evaporation. Because remember, evaporation takes water and makes it into a gas. Next we have erosion. Erosion happens after, you know, the flow of water causes the surface of the earth to change in some way or to form. So it's the flow of water that occurs when excess stormwater, meltwater, or other surface flows over the earth's surface. Can anybody give me an example of a natural phenomenon that happened from erosion?
Landslide?
A landslide, yes. That would be an example of erosion. Anything else? It's okay. So, say, Niagara Falls or the Grand Canyon. These are both big examples of how streams and rivers can erode the earth and create new structures. All right, our final vocabulary term is runoff. Can anybody guess what runoff means?
Is this when the excess water and minerals runs down to the soil?
Yes, so this is where we have excess water from storms that is going to flow from higher levels to lower levels down to sea level. And this is, like you said, it's going to take different materials and minerals and bring them down along with it, fully eroding the earth. So erosion has a lot of different causes and effects. First, we have the erosion that comes from rainfall and surface erosion. Now this is, like we said, as rainfall comes, it'll collect at the top of the mountains and it'll slowly run down, bringing down some minerals with it, creating water flow paths down. It'll make it a very unnatural surface. Another example of its causes and effects are rivers and streams. Now this takes a lot more time than runoff erosion does, because over time, streams will turn into powerful rivers. And as rivers become more and more powerful, they'll bring along some of the the riverbeds and the surrounding landscapes with it. The Grand Canyon is one of the greatest examples of erosion. Over time, the river went from the surface of the earth and was able to sculpt out almost a mile down to where it is today. Over millions of years this happens, and this happens with every river and stream that we see in our lives. Are there any questions?
What did you say again was runoff?
Runoff. So runoff is when we have a collection of rainwater at the top of the mountain that runs down and brings along minerals and other debris with it, and it'll condense or collect down at the bottom in lakes or other rivers and streams.
Thank you.
So I want to do a little activity with you guys to see how much you guys understand about the water cycle. Go ahead and turn this off. So I need your guys' help to help me fill out the four primary stages of the water cycle. On the left, I have given a list of your options, and I've given you 4 empty boxes. I want you to help me fill them out. So let's start here. We have a collection of water in a leak. What is the first process in the water cycle? Yes?
Is it evaporation?
It is. So the first process is evaporation, which remember is liquid turning into its gas stage. I'm gonna take that off of our list. So what happens up in the clouds? Yes?
Is this precipitation?
It is not. Think, first we have evaporation, which makes it into the liquid stage. Now what needs to happen in the clouds before precipitation?
To condense, so it'll be condensation.
It is. First the water must condense, so we have condensation in the clouds. Think, clouds, condensation. We're gonna take that one off the list. Next, the clouds are full of water. Gravity comes into effect. What do we have next?
Precipitation.
Precipitation, yes. Well done. And last but not least, as water flows down from the mountains and collects in the lakes, what is our final step?
Yes.
Runoff. Runoff. And that completes our water cycle. Thank you.